Hi everyone, this is Sheshanand. I just want to give lecture on one simple application using microcontroller, which is keypad and LCD combination by using 8051 microcontroller. So let's see this application overview. I'm from Eretec Solutions. So here you're talking about the application, which is the general keypad. If you're observing, most of the applications contains different size keypads and one screen. You can go with different sizes LCD screens which are available in market. So I'm just combining these two peripherals interfacing with controller. This is your application overview. I just taken individual blocks. One for power supply, and keypad is my input section, and microcontroller unit and LCD screen. So this is a application block representation, and you know that each block importance here very clearly. The power supply requires for AC to DC conversion because all the devices need DC source. So that you need to convert your AC to DC using this power supply. And keypad here I'm using. So most of the electronic systems or products or applications, you may find different matrix keypads. So LCD is my display unit. Let's see the hardware connections with this microcontroller with keypad and LCD. So here I'm using phone keypad, which is the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and start 0 hash. And this ABCD represents rows and 1, 2, 3 represents columns. And from LCD, the connections are very clear. You had to handle the three control pins with IOs and data lines D0 to D7. So this is the physical connection required between keypad and microcontroller and LCD. So now I'll show you the source code of this application, which is already developed in Keil IDE with embedded C language. So this is the clear program. I'm just explaining line by line, please understand. So hash include reg51.h, which is for microcontroller 51 families header file, so that it supports to use all SFR registers from controller. And the three control pins of LCD you need to define individually by using S-bit data type, whereas control pin is connected with 2.0, and here RS stands for registered select. The working of RS pin from LCD is very clear. You need to maintain different logics while sending commands and while sending data. If you are sending commands to LCD screen, you have to make sure RS logic is 0. And while sending text or data to LCD, you have to keep logic 1. So this RS control pin decides what you are trying to send to LCD, whether you are sending commands or you are sending data. And the next control pin RW, which decides what you are doing with this LCD, whether you are doing read operation or write operation. So R stands for read and W stands for write. So this also decides what operation you are trying to do. 0 is for write operation and logic 1 for read operation. And enable pin working is very clear from LCD, which helps to make sure enable pin high to low every time. For every change of data, you have to change your enable pin line logic high to low once every time, so that LCD understand there is a new data which is coming from controller, maybe data or command. For every change of command or data, you have to make sure enable pin high to low with some time delay. And these are your keypad connections. So here R represents row and C represents column. And as from circuit, you need to define the clear connections where you are connecting. So now I'm using port 1 from microcontroller for keypad and 3 control pins for port 2 and data lines of LCD screen which are given to port 3. So here I'm using port 3 directly because I'm using entire port, so that no need to define individual pins. And here I'm taking some user defined functions which requires to use your LCD properly, and one for initialization and LCD disk for sending your strings to LCD, but again you have to send character by character, so that I'm taking string pointer as argument and data function, so which allows character as one argument, so you can pass 1 byte data to through these data lines, and LCD command function which helps to send the command one by one to LCD screen, and delay is required in between each every time high to low operation, you have to call this delay. And so I'm using another delay function here, K delay, which means from key, whenever you are operating keypad, there is a problem with key bounce. So if you want to avoid this key bounce rate, so key bounce means if you are operating only one time, it allows to print multiple numbers on screen. So that in programs, generally you have to go for proper time delays for each key operation. If you are not using these delays between each key operation, so it takes as a multiple press or multiple times operation. Okay, and this is the further reason I am taking this K delay function here, and main logic starts from here. The initial function I am calling here, initialization LCD. So just come to the description of this LCD initialization function. I am using this LCD command function again with the arguments. So the commands are very clear because LCD follows some standard commands which never changes. 38 is the command for deciding activating all the crystals from LCD screen, and 0x10 for moving your shift cursor position to right, and 06 for make your cursor right, and 0c for display on cursor off, and 80 command for first line first position. And so these are the basic commands you need to pass to LCD. And again, if you need to check the command function description, this is your LCD command function. So whatever the argument you are passing from initialization, it will reach to your argument valuable temporary variable. So whatever the argument you are getting from this LCD command function, which is assigned with port 3, because the data lines which are connected across port 3 from controller. But remember, while passing commands, you have to change your control pins logics. RS logic should be 0 compulsory. And whenever you are doing write operation, you have to make sure assign logic 0 for RW and enable pin high to low. Again, I am calling delay between enable high and enable low. So this delay function is executed. So this LCD command which executes based on how many times you are calling from this initialization function. Now come back to the next line of this. I'm straight away giving this LCD display function, which is keypad LCD combo. So this is the text display I'm expecting from screen. So I'm just holding some time with this text screen. And again, I am calling this LCD CMD with 0x01 argument. So this allows to clear the screen because 0x01 is a command value for LCD. It clears the display. Now, I am entering into this infinite logic while of 1. So now, I am trying to scan the keypad. So you should take care of 2 methods from keypad. You can follow either row scanning or column scanning. I am attempting row scanning, so Row scanning means make sure your row logic has zero and check the column conditions so that the entire row which is checked with this logic. So if row 1 is 0, so the other, whenever column becomes 0, then only the user is operated particular key from the keypad. So as per 4x3 keypad, the first key from keypad is 1, the related value I am trying to display on screen, LCD dat. So this function will help to display character 1 on screen, and this is a delay, so which helps to debounce rate of your keypad. And again, the second key I am checking, suppose user is operating second key from the row, then I need to change the value on screen as 2. Again, so this avoids your key bounce. This will follows for every condition. And the third key I am checking here, and I am changing my third key value as 3 in my logic. Once row 1 scanning is over, so because columns are common, so that only one row is scanned at a time, so you cannot scan multiple rows at a time, so that you have to change your row 1 logic as 1 and row 2 logic is 0 now. If you want to scan the second row, you have to change your logic of your row 2 as 0. Then conditions are same, C1, C2, C3, but second row values are changed as 4 and second key value as 5 and third key value as 6. So after second row scanning, then again come for third row just by changing your R2 logic as 1 and R3 logic as 0. This is for scanning third row from the keypad. So from third row, you need to change the value. You need to change the key values every time. For column 1, key value is 7. And for column 2 condition, key value is 8. For column 3, key value is 9. So once row 3 scanning was done, then come for row 4. So just make sure your row 3 logic has 1 and row 4 logic 0. Again, write the same conditions C1, C2, C3 with star 0 hash. So before going back to the row 1 scan again, so make sure R4 logic is 1. So this is the way you have to scan your keypad continuously by keeping all these conditions in while loop, which is infinite loop. Then coming to this LCD display function, so whatever the string you are passing from this LCD display function, which is given to the string pointer, and you know that strings terminates with null character, which is \0. I am comparing with this \0 null character, and every time I am passing each character as argument to this LCD dat function. Coming to this LCD dat function description, so whatever the argument you are passing from this, it will reach this val temporary variable, which is given to port 3. But remember, you have to change your RS control pin logic as 1. And still you are doing write operation with LCD, so RW remains 0. And enable pin high to low for each character. And coming to this K delay function, whatever the arguments you are passing there, so which is 10, 20, 30 as per requirement, you can follow with this number of repetition execution. So this is my embedded C program for keypad and LCD combination. We will see output with this simulation tool, which is Proteus, which is already designed. So most of the engineering students, they are testing applications with these simulation tools. So you cannot proceed directly with the hardware, because hardware is always cost effective. Once you got the application outputs with simulation, you can proceed with hardware. So my hex file is already linked with this application. So just double click on controller. It will ask for program file path, and you need to select your hex file. Click on OK. Now you can play your application. So this is the text display whatever I given in source code, which is erased. Now it accepts the character from keypad. Now if I am pressing 1, then it displays 1. So I'll test all the keys from keypad. Now 2 3, next 4 5 6 7 8 9 *0#. So as per your logic, it allows to print your numbers on LCD screen. So this is the way to develop your simple programming with these peripherals with microcontroller. So if you want to go for more videos, please subscribe us from YouTube, and please subscribe and like, share and comment. And we are in different services. We are doing trainings, even online and classroom trainings, and we will support placement also. We are doing multiple projects which are related to some solutions based on microcontroller and non-microcontroller, and even we are working on operating system level applications and non-operating system applications, which are firmware, and we will deal with Internet of Things, and we will deal with device drivers also. If anyone interested, please get back with this contact number 9676327118 with phone or WhatsApp. And this is our address, which is located near to KPHP metro station from Hyderabad, Telangana, India. And if you have any queries, please call back or you can email with this isnanda@erotechsolutions.com. Thanks for watching.